For my biology role model project, I decided to focus on Dr. Mark S. Gold. He is a researcher who has focused his research in the areas of psychology, psychiatry, and neurology. He has really focused on addiction and a chain of ideas that starts with the idea that drugs change the anatomy and chemicals of the brain. These changes to the brain result in addiction to a particular substance, and this addiction can be treated. Dr. Gold has held many positions during his career. He has been a professor at the University of Florida, Washington University in St. Louis, and Yale. He has been a researcher formulating many hypotheses as to why people become addicted to drugs and what parts of the brain are responsible for this. He has been a mentor to many others in the same fields he has focused on and conducted research in. He is also a physician and avid writer. He attended Washington University in St. Louis for his undergraduate degree. He chose this school because his dad had visited the school for a work-related event and told his son that he thought it would be a good fit for him. Dr. Gold believed his dad, and this was the only school he applied to. He chose his classes in undergrad based upon the professor's popularity and character. He ended up taking the psychology path and obtained a degree in this major. He then went on to medical school at the Florida College of Medicine and did his residency and fellowship at Yale, specializing in psychiatry. All his research stemmed from his interest in the function of the brain. This was stimulated by a volunteer experience he had in a psychiatry research lab while completing his undergraduate degree. As I stated before, his research really stems around addiction and how it affects the brain. Early in his career, he focused on opioids, specifically along with tobacco and cocaine. Later in his career, he shifted to food and eating disorders. He went deep into how to properly treat opioid use disorders and also proved with a group of colleagues that cocaine was addicting. His research has helped reduce the stigma surrounding addiction, working to prove that addiction truly is a disease, and has helped change the treatment of addiction. Some of his major discoveries have included what is now called the state-dependent theory, which he uncovered while working in a memory lab during medical school. He realized that if a student uses amphetamine while studying, they will need to use it again to effectively remember the information later. He received the American Medical Association's National Student Research Award in Neuroscience for this discovery. This discovery led him to focus on a part of the brain called the locus coeruleus. The locus coeruleus is a nucleus in the brainstem with a very high proportion of the neurotransmitter norepinephrine, which is secreted in response to stress. Dr. Gold hypothesized that this area is responsible for withdrawal symptoms due to the stress the body goes through when it craves something. This led him and a team of other researchers to invent the drug clonidine, which is now used for the treatment of opioid withdrawal. His research then took a different turn, and he focused on his dopamine hypothesis, which states that repeated cocaine use causes a depletion of dopamine, which interferes with motor function and causes anhedonia, or the inability to feel pleasure. In his more recent research, he has focused on eating disorders and pioneered the hypothesis of hedonic overeating, which refers to eating for pleasure or eating even though we know that we are not hungry. This idea has become widely known in recent years. Other accomplishments of Dr. Gold's include founding the University of Florida's Florida Recovery Center. He has worked for the DEA, State Department, the NIH, the NIDA, and the NIAAA. He co-authored a breakthrough book about food and addiction. He has received numerous teaching awards and has 29 patents to his name. The most recent paper that Dr. Gold was an author on is titled, "Can Chronic Consumption of Caffeine by Increasing D2-D3 Receptors Offer Benefit to Carriers of the DRD2-A1 Allele in Cocaine Abuse?" The experiment performed in this paper was an animal study trying to determine the role of the adenosine system, which is associated with the sleep-wake cycle, in the release of dopamine induced by cocaine. The Broderick probe biosensor was used to capture real-time images of the drug-induced surges of dopamine release. The experiment determined that with low and high doses of adenosine antagonist, caffeine, and moderate doses of CPT, protection against the cocaine-induced dopamine release occurred. What is next for Dr. Gold? In 2014, he retired from full-time academia. However, he is still an adjunct professor in the Department of Psychiatry at Washington University in St. Louis. He regularly lectures at medical schools across the country, speaking on his research, and frequently attends national scientific meetings on addiction. He is still conducting research on food and addiction, and is the editor of multiple journals. His true passion lies in teaching the next generation of physicians how to properly deal with addiction. He believes that, quote, We don't train physicians to identify and treat drug abusers and dependent people in the same way that we train medical students to deliver babies, respond to a heart attack, or treat high blood pressure. We're better at treating the cancer that results from tobacco smoking or replacing the liver that results from alcoholism than we are at intervening and then treating the primary cause. I chose to do this project on Dr. Gold as I hope to become a physician like him one day, but also want to have the opportunity to perform research in my area of interest. I also love to write, and Dr. Gold has published hundreds of pieces of writing, whether it be books, scientific findings, or journal articles. The main reason I chose Dr. Gold was his area of expertise, addiction. I've seen firsthand how addiction can destroy someone's life and how they lose who they are. Dr. Gold has devoted his life to trying to find ways to help addicts, and I really admire that. What I want in a career is the ability to learn something new every day and help other people. And this is exactly what Dr. Gold has achieved.